Hello everyone. We are back with one more topic which is already asked in AIIMS exam day before. Though we are late, we hope this will help you in next central exams. The topic is vacutainers. So let us start with introduction of vacutainers. Vacutainers are nothing but vacuum containers. This vacuum helps in drawing blood and also maintaining the sample sterile. So these vacutainers are divided into different colors based on the additives added into the bottles. These additives helps in both preserving the specimen and also the stabilizing the values we need. So what are these colors? Here we divide the mammary part into three parts. That is remembering the color, remembering the substance in it, and the use of it. So we start with normal first. Normal blood is red in color. So red bottle either contains no additives or contains silica particles lining the bottle. Silica particles are acts as clot activators. So finally, if we leave blood without adding anything, serum will be formed. So red bottle is used for normal serology. Whatever serum investigations we do, we use red bottle, like virology, drugs, all blood chemistries including electrolytes. So next, coming to yellow bottle, we remember yellow bottle as pus. Pus is nothing but indicates both the substance containing is SPS, pus, sodium polyanethyl sulfonate. Though acid citrate dextrose is not much important, so we need to remember sodium polyanethyl sulfonate. Pus also indicates that yellow bottle is used for culture. There is one more use, which is for HLA studies and enzyme studies. Generally, HLA is asked to remember that yellow bottle is used for HLA studies. We remember HLA as HLO. So, yellow bottle contains sodium polyanethyl sulfonate used for culture and HLA studies. Next, coming to gray bottle. Gray bottle contains fluorides or oxalates, especially sodium fluoride. If we go back and remember glycolysis, the ninth step of glycolysis, where 2-phosphoglycerate is converted into phosphoenol pyruvate using the enzyme enolase. The inhibitor of this enzyme is sodium fluoride. So if we add sodium fluoride here, in this step it inhibits glycolysis. So we can study glucose without glucose being converted into pyruvate. So gray bottle contains sodium fluoride, inhibits glycolysis, used for studying blood glucose. So till now we studied red, yellow and gray. We divide these three into one group, and the other group is bottles containing anticoagulants: light blue, green, purple and pink. So coming to the bottles containing anticoagulants, light blue is the most important one, containing sodium citrate, which is a reversible anticoagulant useful for coagulation studies, especially PTA, PTT, INR and also for D-dimer. We know that D-dimer is fibrin degradation product, is nothing but is a part of inhibition of coagulation. So light blue bottle contains sodium citrate, useful for coagulation studies. Now coming to green bottle. This green bottle contains heparin. For now, we remember heparin as hepagreen, and this is useful for arterial blood gas analysis. We all know our internship, for drawing ABG, we used to draw heparin in a syringe and then collect ABG. So remembering use is not a problem, but color is problem. So to remember the color, green bottle contains hepagreen, useful for ABG analysis. Now coming to purple and pink bottles. Both are girl colors. Both these contain EDTA. To remember these together, remember the both girl colors contain EDTA. And to remember purple bottle, we know that purple is one of the most common bottle we see in our hospitals for all hematological investigations, CBC, ESR, etc. So then pink bottle also contain EDTA. Then how to remember that pink bottle is used for cross matching? Pink is a specifically girl color. So generally we draw female as like this, cross. So pink also contain EDTA but used specifically for cross matching. So let me summarize each bottle in three words. Red bottle, red is a normal blood color, contains normal blood or clot activator, useful for serological investigations. Yellow represents pus. Pus for SPS, sodium polyanethol sulfonate, useful for culture. Pus for culture and also for HLA. Next coming to gray bottle. G for glycolysis. Gray bottle contains glycolysis inhibitor, which is sodium fluoride, useful for blood glucose studies. Next coming to light blue, which doesn't have particular mnemonic. Light blue bottle contains sodium citrate, useful for coagulation studies. Then coming to green bottle. Green bottle contains hepagreen, useful for ABG. And then purple and pink, both containing EDTA, purple for normal hematology and pink for cross matching. So only the bottle doesn't have mnemonic is light blue, which we need to remember somehow. Though not asked till late, because it is mentioned regularly in T&D, which is order of draw of vacutainous, it may be expected as a future bit. Order of draw of vacutainous is important. Why? Because if you draw in particular order, there may occur cross contamination of chemicals present in bottles via the needle. What is the order of draw? The order of draw is yellow, blue, red, green, lavender and gray. How to remember this order? We all know that culture bottles should never be polluted. So we should always draw blood into yellow bottle first. Then coming to blue, red. Why blue before red? We know that red contains clot activator. So this disturbs coagulation studies. So to study coagulation studies without disturbance, we should always draw blood into blue before we draw into red. Then let us compare red and lavender. We already know that red is useful for serology. That is, we measure electrolytes also. That is, red, we use red for serum electrolytes also. For example, we should measure potassium in red bottle. Lavender contain EDTA. EDTA is a potassium containing salt. If we draw blood into EDTA first before red, this potassium will get mixed into blood. So then if we collect potassium from blood, we get false values. So from this example, we should always draw red before lavender. Last is completely different from all these ones. So let us remember glucose, because it is a glycolysis inhibitor, it has nothing much to do with coagulation and anticoagulation. So let us remember it as last one to draw. let me summarize easily. We already know that culture bottles are first, illo first, and then glycolysis inhibitor as last because it is different. So gray last. In between, not to disturb coagulation studies, blue first then red. And not to disturb potassium, we already know red first then lavender. So yellow, blue, red. Only thing we need to remember is green in between red and lavender, gray last. Yellow first, gray last. Blue, red, green and lavender. Hope you liked the video. Thank you.